The scientific method is largely an empirical method. It's based on observation. And when we observe nature, what we are observing is the behavior of nature. When we see a billiard ball hit another, that's a behavior of matter. And what science then does, it analyzes these observations and tries to extract the patterns and regularities of the behavior of physical nature as it presents itself on the screen of perception, conscious perception. So at the end, we end up with predictive models of nature's behavior. We know that if we put things together this and that way, we will get this and that effect. And these predictive models are the heart of technology. We use these models to develop technology because we know how nature behaves, and then we can put that behavior to use to our advantage. And because of the success of technology, science has acquired enormous cachet in our culture as the enabler of the technologies that extend and improve our lives. And this is all fair enough. But science says nothing about the intrinsic nature of the physical. It only analyzes behavior in differential terms, in terms of patterns of differences, bare differences. For instance, what is a positive electric charge? It is that which is not a negative electric charge, because it behaves in a symmetrical, opposite way. That's all science does. But what is a charge intrinsically? What is the nature of a charge? Science has nothing to say about it. It's fundamentally outside the scope of the scientific method. The intrinsic nature of being, of existence, is a question of ontology, a question of philosophy, which has a broader, less precise, but a broader method that's not based only on perceptual observation. It's based on logic, also based on empirical consistency. It's based on certain values, like parsimony. You try to make sense of things with the least number of postulates. And it requires a certain way of thinking and a basic level of acquaintance with the literature that lots of scientists don't have. Some do have, but lots of them, especially the very vocal ones on the media, lots of them don't have. They don't even, they're not even aware of this fundamental distinction. So they end up thinking that science itself is a philosophy, while it has nothing to say about the intrinsic nature of things. And then they spill out nonsense, bullshit, if you forgive my English. Some of these gentlemen we just saw on that video are guilty of this, of being very ignorant of the issues of philosophy, and then doing pseudo-philosophy.